Welcome to Gear Vibe. Today we're going to discuss some of the issues many guitar players face when trying to use the TONEX One as an interface. The TONEX One is designed to function as a standalone unit that you can take anywhere and simply plug and play. However, as soon as you try to use it as a user interface with the TONEX software, there is an issue. When the TONEX One is connected to a PC, we can only hear the A and B amps and the stomp that are set on it. If your instrument input is selected, you will experience this issue. When trying to sample and preview the tone models from the library, the amp running on channel A plays simultaneously with the amp model we want to preview. Another issue is that you might hear the dry signal, the pedal, and the TONEX software all at once. There is a fix for this, but first, we need to review the settings to ensure everything is configured correctly. As for the gear connection, it's as straightforward as it gets. The guitar is connected to the input of the TONEX One, and headphones are plugged into the output of the TONEX One. To power the pedal and control it using the TONEX software, we'll connect the USB-C from the PC to the pedal. Now we need to ensure that the trim settings of the pedal and the software are aligned. But before we do that, change your instrument input to blank. Open the global settings and press the All button on the pedal for 6 to 7 seconds and check the knob's green lights to see if we are clipping. If the right light turns orange or red, it indicates clipping, and we need to adjust the right knob accordingly, either lower or higher. This will ensure that the sound from the TONEX software matches what you hear from the pedal. When you do this with the USB-C connected from the PC to the pedal, the settings will automatically update in the TONEX software as well. Let's discuss the audio settings. Initially, we want to hear only the pedal while controlling it through the TONEX software. In this case, we're simply listening to what is said on the pedal in channel A and B amps and the stomp mode. This setup is useful when we want to check the names of the amps or load a different amp into one of the slots. To ensure everything works correctly, make sure that the monitor settings in the librarian are turned on. These settings can be found to the right of the gear icon. If you want to listen to one of the samples and preview the tone models, you'll need to set the instrument input to TONEX One in One. This is where the issue we're trying to solve begins. Once this setting is configured, the dry signal from the pedal is combined with the wet signal coming from the pedal and the amp model in the TONEX software. To fix this, we need to disable the pedal. Go to the librarian and select the stomp. If you look at the pedal, you'll see it's on. Press it to switch it off. Now, you'll only hear the dry signal along with the selected amp model from the list. To resolve this, go back to the librarian, click the icon next to the gear icon, and check off the monitors. This will ensure that you hear only the amps, with no interference. From here, all that's left to do is check the tones, choose one you like, tweak it, add effects, and you're good to go. If you want that tone on your TONEX One, simply drag it to one of the slots. If you found this video helpful, please leave a comment, like, and subscribe.